if you have two points, latitude and longitude, on a sphere, how do you measure the angular distance between those two latitude and longitude points?
These astronomy students will spend the next 6 hours looking for answers to the mysteries of the universe.
You can think of it this way.
The problem on this night...
The lab itself is to find the distance of the from Earth to the Moon.
But the problem is, we only took one of the measurements, and so we had...
It looks like a typical astronomy class.
Well, the radius of the Earth comes into it.
But look again.
I hope my doctorate to be in astronomy and astrophysics, and specifically in extragalactic and dark matter studies.
I want to work for NASA, or be a professor of astronomy, just like Dr. Stassel.
What's the angular separation between those 2 points?
20
degrees. All right.
If I wanted to integrate both engineering and astronomy, I can go into astronomical instrumentation.
I'll check back in with you in like 20 minutes. And if you're stuck, then let's get you unstuck.
Take a closer look and you find undergraduate and graduate students from Fisk University working side by side with Vanderbilt students.
We've created something that is so far unique in the country, and that is what we call the Fisk-Vanderbilt Masters to PhD Bridge Program.
The program is the brainchild of astronomy professor Kayvon Stassen.
Because you can calculate, you can calculate these just with the little equation.
The goal: to increase the number of minorities getting doctorates in the sciences, from astronomy and physics to material science and biomedical research.
Entire cohorts of minority students who are earning bachelor's degrees in the sciences and aiming for a PhD are recognizing on their own that they need another step in order to get there.
So you two should do that.
That next step for many, including Jedida Eisler, is earning a master's en route to a doctorate, something underrepresented minorities are twice as likely to do.
The students have, in essence, been blazing this trail on their own. What we have done, in essence, with the Bridge Program is to tap into that pathway that the students are pursuing on their own, but formalizing it, systematizing it, and infusing it with deliberate, real guidance and mentorship.
I understand it. I'm just saying, we have this.
This Norfolk State graduate took 2 years off after earning her undergraduate degree, so she wanted additional training before tackling a doctorate, and that led her to the Bridge Program.
It's been an amazing, amazing program. Just because people like Kayvon, who is our program director, he's so adamant about us succeeding. He, as hard as we're willing to work, he's willing to work just that hard, if not harder.
There's an old adage that goes with computer programming. It's garbage in, garbage out.
He's an inspiration to me because I personally would like to have a minority program once I get through school. Everything, I'd like to develop a mentoring program, so he kind of shows me, actually applications-based, how to encourage someone and mentor someone and steer them and help them figure out what they're trying to do.
Jedida is so serious about following in Kayvon's footsteps, she also plans to get her MBA to help her set up a successful mentoring program.
What's your third dimension?
Time.
Oh. Uh-huh. Yeah. Okay.
Hopefully by 2010 I'll have all my degrees in line.
Minorities make up only 3% of all astronomy and astrophysics PhD candidates in this country. If you look at all the universities that offer doctorates in that field, each institution averages one minority PhD every 14 years. The Bridge Program is on track to produce 2 minority PhDs in astrophysics each year, or 10 in 5 years. Combine all the sciences, and that number jumps to 5 PhDs each year, or about 25 every 5 years.
So let's do vertical first.
For these Fisk undergrads, the Bridge Program has already led to invaluable research internships and a chance to do work they love.
There it is.
Okay.
Like the work that we do, it's sometimes it can get hard, and then sometimes it can be tedious. However, like once we get the results, it's amazing.
So fulfilling when you do get the results.
Very like much so.
You work 10 hours, 15 hours, 25 hours, and you finally get a piece, just one little thing, it just like that makes your day.
If you divide integer 48 by integer 60.
For Thompson LeBlanc, the road to becoming the first Bridge PhD candidate started in Puerto Rico. His dream is to work at NASA.
Kayvon actually helped me realize that it was attainable and actually pushed me in that direction.
And that's the part of it that's similar to what we did last
year. Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
But ask Kayvon why he is working so hard on these students' behalf, and you get the real snapshot of a life grounded in making a difference.
I'm the son of a Mexican immigrant, and I was raised by a woman who came to this country believing that the opportunities that would be available here would allow her child to excel and reach peaks that she could only dream of. But more importantly, she viewed it as a new American, that it was a patriotic duty to identify social problems that needed tackling and for me to make a contribution. That narrative has been a very important backdrop for me in terms of staying focused on the kinds of things that matter. And I have found, without exception, that the students who come to our Bridge program come very often for very deeply personal reasons, and it's what sustains them. To hold open doors of opportunity for those people, we find these are folks who are ready, maybe in a way even more sort of strengthened and buttressed against the things that might be thrown at them by virtue of what they've been through already. And so we find that we hold doors of opportunity open, and they are ready to fly.